Hi members, JB here. What is it, Monday 27th of April. Apologies for the hat, but the bouffant has got a bit out of control and it's literally the only way I can keep it tidy. I'm sure I'm not the only one in that boat at the moment. The Queensland Government announced yesterday that they're slightly relaxing some of the social distancing requirements. Just to clarify, there's no changes at the golf club as it pertains to us. So things are moving on as they have been. A couple of weeks ago, we changed the booking process from day to day to releasing the sheets on a Saturday afternoon at 3 o'clock for the following Wednesday through Tuesday after that. We now have 5 weeks worth of data and it's been invaluable. We have good quality information on who wants to play. We can see the booking patterns and behaviours. And I'm happy to say that we've gone from 8% of the playing membership booking 40% of the spots to 1% of the playing membership booking 4% of the spots. So there's been a massive, massive change, and that's credit to the membership. It's most of it's behavioural. We've had a few that we've had to ring up and say, hey, you're booking a few too many rounds and to give someone else a go. And there are still members that are missing out on a game on the day they need to play or want to play based on their work. But it is a big shift, and credit to the membership for that. Saturday is still a big issue, and we're trying to deal with that. But this is a process where we're gradually trying to, assuming that we will be trading like this for a while, we're trying to just narrow it down and come up with something that works. And just to clarify, our system has limitations. It's not built for this. So a lot of what we're having to do at the moment is very manual. So please understand, it's not as simple as pushing a button and making it all work. It just doesn't work like that. So the one thing we're going to do now, the one change for this week, is we're going to ask members that between 3 o'clock on a Saturday afternoon when the sheets are released and close the business on a Tuesday, you only book the two spots that you really, really want. So if you can play through the week and you don't have to play on a Saturday, so in other words, if you don't work or you've got the flexibility to play through the week, can you please play during the week? There are members that are going to miss out on Saturdays, and it's a lot more complicated than many would realise to try and regulate what happens on a Saturday. So if you can play at another time, up to two rounds, then do it. Book those times. For those on a Saturday, if you're more than welcome to try and book your Saturday spot, put your name on the wait list if you can't get it, and only book one other round during the week. Now that's through that window between 3 o'clock on a Saturday afternoon and close of business on a Tuesday. After close of business on a Tuesday, there will be spots available. If everyone does the right thing and only books their two spots, there will be spots available, then you can go for it, okay? I really just wanna make sure that everybody is getting a fair opportunity to get a game of golf at the moment. Very important. Aside from that, we're opening more spots. So during the week, we're going to, from next Wednesday, you might have seen on the timesheets, we're extending it to 6:30 in the morning. The challenge there is that we've got to coordinate the greenkeeping staff to mow greens. We've got noise restrictions, all that sort of stuff. It's not as easy as it seems. But we've found a way to do it, and we're going to do that from next week. You might notice too, health workers, if you're a health worker, can you please make contact with the office and get your name on the list? We've got reserved spots for health workers at the start of the field. We understand that a lot of you do shift work, and where you do an afternoon shift, a morning game is ideal. You can come in, have your game, and get out and go to work. And obviously everybody appreciates what health workers are doing at the moment. We've got My Club, so cardless score entry, so mobile phone score entry. We're currently working on that, so I'll report on that again next week. We're making progress, so hopefully that'll be released soon. And we're going to close the course Tuesday, 5th of May. We are going to proceed with our overso. So things are looking pretty stable at the moment. It looks like we'll be able to continue trading, as long as everyone does the right thing, of course. And so we're going to proceed with overso. So the greens won't be great for a couple of weeks, but as we all know, the last couple of years during the wintertime, our greens have been absolutely fantastic. So we're a golf club. That's where our hard-earned money should go. And so that's what we're going to proceed with and do. Some of the issues we've been having, we know there has been alcohol brought onto the golf course. We found some empty beer bottles in the locker room. I've got no idea why anyone would even contemplate leaving them in there. Don't do it. It's inconsiderate to your fellow members. You're putting our club at risk. If you're caught, we have cameras around the clubhouse. If you're caught, you're going to be out. It's as simple as that. We're not going to tolerate somebody breaching our liquor license. We are not allowed to drink. We're not allowed to consume alcohol. We're not allowed to serve alcohol. So just don't do it. And I encourage any member, if you know of someone doing it, they're jeopardising our access to golf right now. So please, if you know of it, feel free to make contact and we'll deal with it. Slow play. We look, most of us are getting around in 3 hours to 3 hours 20. It's somewhat amusing that it's a bit of an issue that's considered slow, but you know, it can, playing Griff's too, it can feel a bit slow. I do understand. Look, a couple of tips. If you lose your ball, you've only got 3 minutes. That's not 3 minutes you looking for it, and then 3 minutes your partner looking for it. It's 3 minutes, and then you just move on. We've found people fossicking for golf balls, looking for golf balls. Don't do it. You're just holding up the field, okay? It's not the time or place to be doing that. I've had some questions around the putter and the practice green and the chipper being closed. While we're restricted to two people, being in any sort of contact or congregation with each other, it's impossible for us to manage that. So we're not going to risk it. It's just not worth it. So that'll continue until those rules are relaxed. I believe WA has now relaxed their rules. So you know, if we're lucky, that'll come through in Queensland. Just a quick reminder, it's been a big one tonight, quick reminder that we're going to, I'll provide an update on the club's financial position after this Thursday's board meeting to all the members. So far it looks like, you know, we're going to get through this, and if people keep doing the right thing and we're still permitted to trade, things are going to look good for us and going forward. So we'll give you some information on that. Otherwise, hope everyone's having a great time out there. There's a really great vibe at the club. It's really positive. You know, I can see how much everybody's extracting from this in terms of their mental health, and happy golfing, everyone.